We have studied the condition for any number k to lie between the roots of a given quadratic equation. Let's talk about if the number k lies outside both the roots, that is, it is either greater than both the roots or less than both the roots. For this, obviously we need to have an equation which has real roots, hence d should be greater than or equals to 0. So let's talk about the case where a is greater than 0 and d is also greater than 0, and assume that this equation has two roots, alpha and beta. We can notice that here in both the scenarios, be it k more than the roots or less than the roots, a into f of k is always greater than 0. See, a is greater than 0 and f of k greater than 0. Hence we get one of our condition that a into f of k should be greater than 0. And our first condition was that d should be greater than or equal to 0. Now to know which side of the roots does k lie, we can perform a simple trick. We need to find the value of x for which the given equation has the least value. That value of x, as we have learned, is minus b by 2a. If k is greater than this value, that is, if k is greater than minus b by 2a, then it is more than both the roots, else it is less than both the roots. Thus, combining our three conditions, we get the first one, that d should be greater than or equal to 0 to ensure that this equation has real roots. The second, that the product of a into f of k should be greater than 0 to ensure that k lies outside both the roots. And the third condition, that if k is greater than minus b by 2a, then k is more than both the roots. And if k is less than minus b by 2a, then k is less than both the roots. Similarly, let's try for the case when a is less than 0 and d is greater than 0. If we assume any number k that lies outside alpha and beta, where alpha and beta are its roots, then the product of a into f of k will be greater than 0, because a is less than 0 and f of k is always less than 0. We can see from the graph that f of k is less than 0 and a is also less than 0. So a negative into a negative is equal to positive. So the product of a into f of k is greater than 0. So our conditions remains the same. The difference in this case would be that we will be comparing k to that value of x for which the given function takes the maximum value instead of the minimum value, which is minus b by 2a again. So the three conditions in this scenario would be the same as the one where a was greater than 0.